Welcome to DeLawrence at Home. My name is Fira, and I'm one of the educators from the Lawrence Hall of Science, and welcome to today's story time. So today we're doing another episode of Stories in STEAM, where we share the stories of scientists and their great contributions to science. Now before we begin our video, please give this video a like and subscribe to our channel for more science content, and let's get into the story right away!
So today we're gonna read the story of Claudia Alexander, From Jupiter to Its Moons and Beyond. And for our story today, we're actually going to refer to this poster of Claudia Alexander that was made by Anna Suya Lyons. So Anna is a third-year physics student here at UC Berkeley, and in addition to loving physics and science and research, she also loves doing art. So she created a bunch of these beautiful posters to celebrate Black physicists, and this is one of them. And I think her art is really beautiful. And if you want to see more of her art, you can check out her portfolio at annasuyalyons.com. So now let's get into the story. So Claudia Alexander is a NASA geophysicist and project manager. But first of all, how did she discover what she wanted to do? So let's learn a little bit more about her early life. So originally, Claudia wanted to be a journalist, which is very different from being a scientist. But her parents, who were paying for her education, wanted her to go into engineering. And then after a summer job at the NASA Ames Research Center, which is this one located in San Jose, Claudia grew to love the planetary sciences. And despite being hired to the engineering section, she often sneaked into the science section of the research center. And there she found that she was good at the work and found that it was more enjoyable. So that was how she got into planetary sciences. And that is why Claudia decided to study geophysics, because she believed that it gives her a nice understanding and basic of planetary sciences. So after earning her bachelor's in geophysics at UC Berkeley, go Bears, Claudia Alexander moved to the University of Michigan, where she studied space plasmas. After earning her PhD in 1993, Dr. Alexander began working for NASA, where she would remain for the rest of her career. That sounds really fun. So what did she do during her career? She served as a project manager for the Galileo mission to Jupiter, which discovered 21 new moons and revealed that the moon Ganymede had an atmosphere previously unknown to scientists. So these were the things that she worked on. Let's dive a little bit deeper into them, shall we? So as mentioned in the poster, her most significant contribution is with the Galileo mission. So this is the Galileo spacecraft, and it was launched from Earth to Jupiter in 1989, and it arrived on Jupiter in 1995. So it took 6 years for the spacecraft to travel from Earth to Jupiter. Wow, that took quite a long time. So after it arrived, its mission is to observe Jupiter and look into its atmosphere, its clouds, and also its moons. And we call the moons of Jupiter the Jovian moons. And remember that Galileo is an uncrewed spacecraft, meaning that there's no astronaut who controls the spacecraft from the inside. So that is why we need Claudia and the team that she led to observe the observations of the spacecraft from Earth, to monitor it from Earth. So currently, 79 Jovian moons have been discovered, and Claudia helped discover 21 of them, which is really cool. And the mission also helped discover an atmosphere in one of the moons, and that moon is Ganymede. So originally, Ganymede was thought as an inactive moon, but the discovery of an atmosphere on Ganymede caused scientists to rethink that. Perhaps Ganymede is an active moon because it has an atmosphere. So those were some of the things that she worked on. And Alexander's research interests were really broad, spanning from plate tectonics to the solar wind to the interior of comets. And when not studying the solar system, she wrote children's books and science fiction. So now let's learn a little bit more about her impacts, since she obviously did so many things during her career. So as mentioned earlier, Claudia's research has resulted in many discoveries in really diverse topics. The first one, of course, being the Galileo missions and the discovery on Jupiter and its moons, but she also studied the evolution and the interior physics of comets. She also did some studies on Venus. She also had some research on solar wind and so much more. So she has a lot of impact to the scientific community because all of the research that she has done. And lastly, Claudia is also a huge inspiration for a lot of aspiring scientists, myself included. She was a strong advocate for women and minorities in STEM. She also gave a TED Talk on her approach for educating children about science, and she also mentored young people, mostly people of color, young girls of color even more specifically, to encourage their passions for science. And with that, we've reached the end of our story time today. Thank you so much once again to Anna for creating this beautiful poster. And I feel like you should totally check out the other posters that she made because they're all really amazing. And if you want to do that, make sure to check out her portfolio again. It's annacialeons.com, and we'll also include the link in the description below.
So thank you so much for tuning in to our story time today. I hope you enjoyed learning about Claudia Alexander and the Galileo mission, Jupiter, and so much more. Be sure to give this video a like and subscribe to the Lawrence Hall of Science YouTube channel for more science content. And I will see you next time. Bye, everyone!